I want people to understand that the service, I believe the service, the Forest Service, really does believe that ecological restoration holds the best path to prosperity of the people, the environment, this planet.
In terms of any single entity really in the state of California that has an opportunity or an obligation even, you know, through restorative work and through progressive ecological management, I mean, we're the ones, right?
Ecological restoration is taking an ecosystem and making it more resilient to the kind of disturbances which inherently will occur.
It's assisting recovery of an ecosystem that's been damaged, degraded, or destroyed.
It's the returning of ecosystem components and processes back to a functioning condition.
So ecological restoration is like not an event, you know, it's a process.
A lot of the forests, particularly in the western United States, are not very healthy.
The landscape is so huge.
We manage nearly 20 million acres in California.
It's really going to be a whole host of things.
Fuels reduction projects, veg management projects, water projects.
Reforestation, meadow restoration, hydropower management.
Habitat restoration projects, monitoring wildlife.
Restoring what we would call function, restoring what we would call processes.
The Forest Service is going to attempt to help the ecosystems and our habitats respond to the disturbance regime.
And disturbance may be something such as wildfire,
climate change,
invasive species,
sudden oak death, flooding, landslides,
bark beetle attacks,
human population increases, and those kinds of things.
We have a big challenge.
Probably the biggest challenge right now is that we have a diverse group of stakeholders.
Resources are limited, budgets are tight, so we, by necessity, have to find ways to work better together.
This is a good time for everyone to work toward making these ecosystems more resilient.
It's more challenging now because we know that there's this global climate change occurring.
Big wild card. We don't know how that's going to play out.
And the more we work on trying to figure out how to restore the forest, the more we find that we have to be humble and realize how complex it is.
We can make a difference if we'll act, and act pretty quickly. The forest we help today will be the forest that we have tomorrow.
The way we've set up these public trust resources are to manage them for the American public for now and into the future.
We've all sort of inherited a sacred trust, and we're here for a short amount of time, and then we actually have the privilege of gifting that trust to a future generation.